Thank you. It's a pleasure to be in Bangalore. So the next two pieces I'm going to play are two preludes by Villalobos, pretty standard guitar repertoire. After that, the program's going to take a massively different turn in a totally different direction. When we get to that, I'll talk a little bit about it then. But until there, here's two preludes by Villalobos. Thank you. Perfect timing. How about that? Early today, I actually checked in with the church for what time they would be ringing those bells so I could end the piece perfectly in sync with it. Yeah. So here's where the program takes a decidedly different turn in terms of repertoire. Next, I'll be playing a series of three etudes that I arranged. All of them are based on the Mellicarda system. I've donated a copy of this book that I worked on. It was published 2 weeks ago by Mel Bay in the U.S. I have a copy for donation for the Bangalore School of Music, so if you like what you hear, well, you can now check your school library. And it was a pleasure working on these because it's opened me up to a whole different way of listening to the guitar, to scales, and adapting something from an entirely different system. So I hope you enjoy. This is actually the first public performance I'm doing of these, as well as later in the program, my arrangements of Debussy and Albanis. So it's familiar rep with a little bit of a new twist on it. Thank you. guitar really hates me for what I'm gonna do next, but it's gonna be upset a little bit later too. So I have to structure the program this way because through a lot of things I'm playing, I have to put the guitar into a lot of really different tunings. So now we're going to drop C flat, which is technically the same as drop B, but it's C flat. Thank you. So that's three Indian etudes arranged by me, originally composed by, ironically, an Indian woman living in San Francisco for the San Franciscan guitarist living in India. So it's kind of funny how that worked out. So next I'm just going to be playing one bagatelle from William Walton's five bagatelles. So you get 1/5 of the awesomeness that is that set of pieces. I'm going to take a little pit stop to double check the tuning on the old guitar, because after here we're going to stay in an extended period in D. Like, no matter how many years I've been playing this thing, it still takes forever to tune. Thank you. are moving to Spain. So I'm going to play four selections by Albéniz. The first two are of the slower, more lyrical nature. The second two have more of a flamenco influence. As guitarists and at a guitar festival, these are the pieces that none of the performers ever end up playing, but all the students want to do. So hopefully you hear something new in these. These are all my own arrangements for these four. Thank you. Thank you. Next is Capriccio Catalan. Happens to all of us. Mulligan. There we go. Thank you. Thank you. For the students in the audience, I would recommend cultivating the skill of making your mistakes sound fun. You never know when that might come in handy. You're going through a shift past the 12th fret, and there's candles, and you think you might set your leg on fire, and then before you know it, you're on the wrong note. Yeah. That's what I learned when I was in school. That's what we teach at KM Music Conservatory, too. So next is the piece that doesn't really need much of an introduction. It's Leyenda. Yeah, here, Dad, this is for you. Thank you. Thank you. So next I'll be premiering my arrangement of Debussy's Clair de Lune. It's originally for piano. And today you're going to hear it on guitar. So I'd like to thank Len, Nandini, Deepak, Carl, back there, Sonia, everyone else who's come out and helped put together this performance and this workshop for the students. It means a lot to me to be a part of it, and I hope you guys are enjoying yourself as part of this performance. The next piece I'm going to play is Hika. And since I heard Len is really into Brouwer, this one's for you. But it involves getting the guitar into another wild tuning. Thank you.